How are we doing tonight, church? Good to see you in the house of God tonight. You guys excited to be in the house of God? Hallelujah.
Yes.
Yeah. So every time I get to speak, I'd like to listen to a song. So we'll listen to a song, and I just invite you guys just to cast all your care upon Jesus. Amen. I love that verse, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. So we're going to do that right now. And we'll just relax, just, you know, repent, whatever you need to do to get right with God and just to be open to God's word and to receiving your blessing tonight. Amen. Say this with me tonight. Say, I'm going to be blessed tonight. Hallelujah. That was kind of weak. Say, I'm going to be blessed tonight. Hallelujah. So let's play that song. And yeah, you can just stay seated or whatever you want to do. Close your eyes, shout, praise, stand up, worship, whatever. I do would advise you to just get uncomfortable, amen? We want to get uncomfortable. We want to be in a position to receive from God, okay? Hallelujah. Thank him. Lord, we praise God. Thank you. We give you praise and honor and glory and worship tonight. God, you are a good God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. God is good all the time and all the time. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Come on. Give him praise. Give him praise. Praise Jesus. Praise him for what he's done for you. Hallelujah. Give him praise for what he's done and worship him for who he is. Praise him for the cross. Praise him for him bringing you out of Egypt and parting that Red Sea. Hallelujah. He parted that Red Sea for you. You came out of that darkness. Those demons have left you. Amen. Those demons are under your feet. That disease has lost its authority over your life. Why? Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Come on. Are you passionate about Jesus Christ? Are you thankful? Jesus said, because I live, ye shall also live. That's good. Come on, because Jesus is alive, you get to have life. He lives inside of you. Romans chapter 8, verse 11. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body by his spirit that dwelleth in you. That is amazing news. That is good news. Do you believe that the Holy Ghost is living inside of you? Do you believe that he's with you right now? Do you believe that he's guiding you, helping you, protecting you, watching you, blessing you, healing you, delivering you, changing you, transforming you, resurrecting you? You're being transfigured by the love and the power and the glory of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. But I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service, and be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. Hallelujah. Be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may prove what is that good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Thank you, Lord. Thank him you're being transformed. Come on, if you don't open your mouth, if you don't put your mouth into operation, then you're going to stay stuck. The Bible says, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Hallelujah! You've been redeemed from the hand of the enemy. The devil can't bind you anymore. The devil can't torment you anymore, poor devil. He can't destroy your life anymore. Amen. You're coming out. You're coming out of that mess. Amen. Yes. Thank you, Lord. Thank him. Thank him. Put your mouth in operation. Come on. Boldly. Yes. Thank you, Lord. We thank you for the cross. We thank you for the shed blood of the cross. We thank you for divine power in our lives. We thank you for your word. According to Psalm chapter 107:20, he sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destructions. Thank you, Lord. Yes. Deliver us from our destructions, O God. chico rodron basilo ko shabadrado kolo. Ba 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 yo 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 rababa shaka sondro. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you're here in a mighty way. Thank you for bringing the people of God tonight, God. You brought them here. You told them to come here, and they're here tonight. Hallelujah. And they're going to get blessed because they obeyed you. And they're going to be healed because they listened to your voice. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you. Come on, thank Him. Thank Him that you're having a fantastic year. Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, we're in the middle of the year right now. Are you accomplishing kingdom goals? Where do you want to be at for the rest of this year? I say your word for the rest of this year should be surrender. Hallelujah. We're going to surrender to God. You're going to submit to God. You're going to surrender to God. Then you're going to resist the devil. Submit yourselves, therefore, to God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you. Draw nigh to God, and he will draw nigh to you. Come on, draw near to God right now. Do it right now. By faith. By faith, just draw near to God. Thank you, Lord. We draw near by the blood of the Lamb. We draw nigh by the blood of the Christ, the resurrected Christ, the living Christ, the glorious Christ, Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord. Be glorified in this place. Be magnified in this place, Jesus of Nazareth. Be exalted, be glorified, be magnified, Jesus of Nazareth, in this place. Touch your people, bless your people, help your people. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Say this for me. Say, Jesus, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You're here. I'm ready. Thank you, Lord. Can you shut that door for me, brother? So let's pray. So tonight I want to talk about kingdom prayer. We need powerful prayer lives. Amen. And in John chapter 16, verse 24, Jesus said, Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Ask and ye shall receive, that your joy may be full. Hallelujah. What a beautiful promise. That when you ask, you're going to receive. And when you receive, you're going to receive that joy. Amen. You're going to have joy because you know Jesus is alive. Amen. You're going to have great joy in your soul, in your spirit, on your mind. You're going to have great joy because Jesus is with you. He's the living God, and he's made a way for you. Amen? Amen. Let me pray. Lord, thank you for this message about prayer. Help us tonight. Speak through me. Touch your people. Bless your people. Thank you for the end times army of the church of Jesus Christ. Have your way tonight in Jesus' name. Everybody said amen. Amen. So once again, I want to focus on kingdom prayer, because from what I see, it seems like there's a lot of the church that just doesn't pray. Okay? A church that doesn't do spiritual warfare. They just want to ignore the devil. And when all hell breaks loose and things go wrong, everybody wants to blame God. Right? That's what happens all the time. A passive, comfortable church. But I want to light a fire in you tonight. And I want to teach you how to pray so you could stand against the enemy and pray like Jesus taught us to pray. Amen. We need to know how Jesus taught us to pray and just simply do that. In James chapter 4, verse 7 and 8, the Bible says, submit yourselves therefore to God. That just means that we're going to obey God. I talk about that scripture every time I'm here. It's a powerful scripture. I love that scripture. Submit yourselves therefore to God. What does that look like in your life? Submitting to God. Amen. We have to be able to submit to God in a practical way and just say, Jesus Christ, I surrender my life to you. I'm not in control anymore. You're in control. Amen. Can we just say, Jesus, you're in control. I'm not God. Hallelujah. You're not God. I hate to burst your bubble, but you're not God, okay? Jesus is God. And we need to be able to submit to him. Then you're going to resist the devil. That means to stand against him, to oppose him. And we know what that looks like, amen? To stand against him and oppose him means that you're just not going to agree with him anymore. You're not going to believe his lies anymore. And you're going to take a stand against him and you're going to do what's right. Can I just tell you tonight that doing what's right will take away Satan's power? Amen? That's practical. Doing what's right will take away the enemy's power over your life. Hallelujah. So, and then you're going to draw nigh to God and he's going to draw near to you. That's prayer. That's kingdom prayer. You're going to draw. We do that on a daily basis. We want to. We want to wake up in the morning. We're excited about getting into the Word. We're excited about saying, Jesus, good morning, Holy Ghost. Say that. Say, good morning, Holy Ghost. Say that every morning. Amen. Cleanse your hands, ye sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. So kingdom prayer is key to being a successful Christian. Come on, you want to be a successful Christian? Yeah. Yes? Yes, sir. The foundation of the local church must be prayer. Is prayer a priority in your life? It's a good question. Do you love to pray? Is prayer supernatural and effective in your life? Or is prayer boring? Wow. If prayer is boring, it's because you're boring. God is not boring. Amen? The problem is you, not God. Hallelujah. Prayer was the foundation of Jesus Christ's ministry. He always prayed, didn't he? What an amazing Lord. He always prayed. And he taught us how to pray. Look at Luke chapter 18, verses 1 through 8. Let's break this down. Luke chapter 18, verses 1 through 8. Jesus is speaking, is telling us of a parable here. And he says in verse 1, that men always ought to pray and not lose heart. That's good, isn't it? Men always ought to pray and not lose heart. So the Lord is just saying that we always ought to be praying. No matter what is going on, no matter what is wrong. Even when life is fantastic and everything's going great. Right? When everything's good, we still worship, we still pray. Amen? And verse 2, saying there was in a certain city a judge who did not fear God nor regard man. Now there was a widow in that city, and she came to him, saying, avenge me of mine adversary. And he would not for a while. But afterward, he said within himself, though I do not fear God nor regard man. Verse 5, yet because this widow troubles me, I will avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. That's good. Amen. Then the Lord said, hear what the unjust judge said. And shall God not avenge his own elect who cry out day and night to him? Though he bears long with them, I tell you that he will avenge them speedily. Nevertheless, when the Son of Man comes, will he really find faith on the earth? Okay, so that's a powerful parable. What I like is that Jesus uses the word avenge 4 times. Say that when we say avenge. Amen. So the Greek word for avenge is ekdikeo, and what that literally means is to vindicate, to retaliate, to do one justice, to protect and defend and punish a person for a thing. Hallelujah. Jesus, when you pray, he's going to vindicate you. He's going to retaliate, defend you, and get justice and punish Satan for you when you pray. Hallelujah. That's what he's going to do for you. When you pray, he's going to retaliate for you. He's going to punish the enemy. He's going to protect you and defend you and get justice for you. Then why are we not praying? Hallelujah. Come on, can I encourage you tonight? Why are we not praying like we ought to? I'm preaching to myself, amen? I'm speaking to myself too. We ought to be praying more. Because God is going to make it happen. He's going to vindicate us and defend us. 3 things that we learn from the widow. Number one, the Bible says that she came unto him. We need to always pray first and come to God first. Don't let the kingdom of God be the last resort. We look to God and we come to God first. Amen. Matthew 6:33, seek ye first the kingdom of God. Say first. Amen. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. Hebrews 12:2, looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith. So we always look to God first and we come to God first. When problems arise, where do we go? God, amen. That's what she did. The Bible says she came unto him. Number two, she spoke and said something. She put her mouth into operation. And that's what we need to do. In Mark chapter 11, verse 23, the Bible says, whoever says unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and does not doubt it in his heart, but believes those things he says will come to pass, he or she will have whatever he says. Amen. And so that's a repeated action. You're just constantly, continuously saying, amen. And whatever you want, whatever you're praying for, we're just saying it. We're just declaring it. We're just asking for it repeatedly, amen. It's not a one-time thing. We don't just ask God for something once and then give up and then be filled with unbelief and then just retract to the lies of the enemy, amen. She said something. She put her mouth into operation. Revelation 12:11. They overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Amen. You have a powerful testimony. You're going to put your mouth into operation during prayer. Amen. We cannot pray, be avenged by God, and overcome Satan quietly, silently, passively, and lazy. Amen. Praise God. We need to be aggressive. We need to be bold. We need to be courageous. We need to be filled with faith and passion for God and his word. You have to put your mouth, you have to open your mouth powerfully and say, speak, command, loose, renounce, and take your stand. Amen. In 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 1, the Bible says, speaking of a woman named Hannah in the Old Testament, Hannah prayed and said. That's what we need to do. We need to pray and say. Amen. The Bible says, Hannah prayed and said, my heart rejoiceth in the Lord. Mine horn is exalted in the Lord. My mouth hath been large over my enemies. I love that. Your mouth needs to be large over the enemy. Say that today. Say, poor devil, you are defeated. Say that again and believe it. Say, poor devil, you are defeated. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So you're going to put your mouth into operation. You're going to believe what you say. And your mouth needs to be large over the enemy, just like Hannah. I love it. She said, my mouth had been large over my enemies. Large over disease. Large over fear. Large over sin. Large over witchcraft. Large over death. Large over poverty. Is that good? And then number three, she troubled the judge, continually came to him and cried out day and night. We need to be able to do that. We need to be able to come to God and cry out to him day and night. Can you do that? The Bible says in Jeremiah 33:3, call unto me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things which you do not know. When you cry out to God, I said this last week, God is going to answer you. He's going to give you a revelation. God is the author and finisher of your faith. He's going to give you reasons to continue to follow him. He's going to give you reasons to build your faith and to keep crying out to him. In Psalm chapter 30, verses 1 through 3, David said, I will extol you, O Lord, for you have lifted me up and not let my foes rejoice over me. O Lord, I cried out to you and you healed me. God is going to heal you when you cry out to him. She did that. The Bible says she cried out to the judge day and night. Amen. Let's see. What did Jesus say that she said? Jesus said that she came to him. I tell you that he will avenge him speedily. He said, the Lord said in verse 7, and shall not God avenge his own elect who cry out day and night to him, though he bears long with them. That can be you. Amen. You're going to cry out to God day and night, and you're going to get an answer, and you're going to get a breakthrough, and that devil is going to be under your place, under your feet, and you're going to have the victory. You're going to be healed. You're going to get that deliverance that you've been praying for. You're going to get that breakthrough you've been seeking God for. You're going to go to that next level in your prayer. You're going to go to that next level in your walk with Jesus Christ because you've been crying out to him, because you've been seeking him, and the Bible says, ask, and it shall be given to you. Seek, and you shall find, and it shall be, come on, give Jesus a hand clap. Do we got to do our part? Do we got to pray? Yeah. Can we pray? Yeah. Hallelujah. It's easy to get comfortable and spend hours on Facebook and watch Netflix all day and get comfortable and just say, God, I need you to do this, Lord. Thank you for doing it for me. And then praying for 1 minute. Wow. Imagine that. You've been serving Satan for 30 years and living like hell and believing like hell and talking like hell, but then you get born again and now you want God to fix your life overnight. Well, guess what? God wants you to pray. God wants you to do your part. God wants you to submit to Him and pray and resist the devil and cry out to Him day and night. Call unto me and I will answer you. God is going to give you a divine encounter. God is going to give you exactly what you need. You know what you need to move forward. You know what you need to grow. And He knows what you need. All you need to do is cry out to Him. He's going to give it to you. Amen. He's going to show you His face. He's going to give you a vision. You're going to hear a small, still voice guiding you, telling you what to do, not to do this. And yes, go there. And yes, pray for that person and cast out that devil and do this and give a certain amount of money and go here and do this. Amen. He's going to guide you. He is with you. Hallelujah. But we need to do our part and simply submit to Him, cry out to Him. I love what King David said in Psalm chapter 27, verse 1. Gosh, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? So once again, we're talking about prayer. Amen. Kingdom prayer. And prayer is how we communicate with God. Prayer is man releasing the kingdom on earth. Prayer is the government of the kingdom coming to earth through man. Prayer is God keeping His promises to us. Prayer is not talking about our problems. Amen. Prayer is not talking about our problems. Prayer is not telling God what is wrong. Okay, is that good? Prayer is not manipulating God for personal self-gain. Prayer is not saying what's wrong or what we see. Let me say that again so it makes sense to you. Prayer is not saying what's wrong or what we see. It's saying what we desire according to the Word of God. Prayer is simply saying, God, I have this desire according to Your will, according to Your Word. Amen? It's saying the promise that's going to fix the problem. So what you're saying is you're praying the promise of God, and it's going to fix the problem. In Joel chapter 3, verse 10, the Bible says, let the weak say, I am strong. Okay? And God did this during creation. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 3, and God said, let there be light. And there was light. Right? But what did God see, though, when He said that? Darkness on the face of the deep. Right? So what God didn't say what He saw. God said His desire. God said His word. And so like you, you're not going to say what you see. You're not going to say what the devil is doing. You're not going to say what the problem is right now. You're not going to speak on what the symptoms are right now. You're not going to be negative and discouraged. You're going to speak the promise of God. You're going to say your desire according to the word of God. You're going to speak God's word. Amen. You're going to pray the word, the promise. The King has given us keys to the kingdom for prayer. He has given us keys to the kingdom for prayer. Keys give you authority to open and close. Right? To change your destiny and change the lives of other people. What are we doing with the keys of the kingdom that Christ has given us? In Matthew chapter 16, verse 19, Jesus said, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven. The word keys is the Greek word kleis, literally means power to open and shut. It denotes power and authority. And Christ has given us this power and authority. He has given us the keys of the kingdom. Do you believe it? Yes. Now the word bind there, when Christ said bind, is the Greek word deo, which means to bind, tie, fasten, to fasten with chains. Okay? Now the word loose is the Greek word luo, to loose, which means to loose any person, to loose one that is bound, to unbind, to release from bonds, to set free. people that are bound with chains, a prisoner, discharge from prison to let go. Hallelujah. I can humble myself tonight and say that I have been released from the chains of the devil. Hallelujah. Thank God for the power of Jesus Christ that is going to release you from the bonds of the enemy. Amen. You are being released from darkness. Hallelujah. To light, from the power of darkness. What was Paul's calling in Acts 26:18? To open their eyes, right? He's opening your eyes and turn them from the power of Satan unto God. Amen. Jesus shows us how to properly bind and loose when he spoke about binding the strong man, who is Satan, and when he loosed a woman of back problems in the Gospels. In Matthew 12, 28 and 29, the Bible says, but if I cast out devils by the Spirit of God, and the kingdom of God has come unto you, or else how can one enter a strong man's house and spoil his goods, except he first bind the strong man, that's that word deo, and then he will spoil his house. In Luke 13, 12, Jesus said, the Bible says, when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said to her, woman, thou art loosed from thine infirmity. Luke 13, 16, Jesus said, ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan had bound, lo, these 18 years, be loosed? That's that word again, luo, from this bond on the Sabbath day. Shouldn't we be loosed from the enemy? Amen. Shouldn't we be released from his lies? Don't we have a right to be released from bondage and torment? Don't you have a right to be free? Why? Jesus Christ and what he did for you, amen? You've already been bought with the price. It is already done. Jesus said it is finished. And because of what Jesus did, and because of who Jesus is, and because of what Jesus is doing, you have a right. Ought not you be free from the rotten, defeated devil, amen? I'm telling you, you're going to have the victory. I'm telling you, your life is going to be changed. I'm telling you that you are making progress, and you are growing, and you are coming out, and God is going to bless your life. Do you believe that? He's given us the keys to open and shut, power and authority to bind, fasting with chains, evil spirits, to release people that are bound and to set free, and to discharge from prison the people of God that are under demonic influence, disease, and sickness. Kingdom prayer, according to the word of God, will bring righteous change. Amen. I am the righteousness of God. Say that with me tonight. I am the righteousness of God. You are the righteousness of God. And when you pray, you are stomping hell and you are saying, not anymore, devil. You're saying, devil, you are exposed. You let me go. You let my family go. And you can say that boldly because you are righteous by the blood of the Lamb. Amen. That's what prayer is. That's what kingdom prayer is. Because of your right standing with God through the Christ, your petitions and prayers will be answered. Do you believe that? Your petitions and your prayers, because you are right with God, because you are the righteousness of God, because Jesus Christ died for you, because Jesus Christ shed his blood for you, and because 2 Corinthians 5:21, for he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God, because you are the righteousness of God, your prayer, your petitions will be answered by the living God. Amen? That is powerful. James 5:16, the effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man, amen, availeth much. When we approach God in prayer, it must be according to his word. God honors his word. Prayer is a spirit realm action, not a mental exercise. Prayer should always be in the spirit. In Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17 and 18, the Bible, Paul said, and take the helmet of salvation, and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. So there are two realms of existence, the spiritual realm, which we cannot contact through our natural senses, right? And then in the natural realm. The natural realm, which we do contact with our senses, which is sight, touch, hearing, taste, and smell. The spirit realm is just as real as the natural realm. Is that true? Now, the spiritual realm controls the natural realm. Say that's good. It's going to influence, change, or shape things and circumstances in the natural realm. Do you want results in the natural realm? Right? Yes, certainly we do. We certainly do. We want results. We want effective results in the natural realm. And when you pray in the spirit, it's going to affect the natural realm. Look at 2 Corinthians 4:18. Paul lays it out for us. Paul says, while we look not at the things which are seen, that's the natural realm, right? But at the things which are not seen, that's the spiritual realm. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. Now the word look in the Greek is the word skopeo, which means to take aim at or regard. So during prayer, we're taking aim at and we're regarding the spirit realm through prayer, which is going to affect the natural realm. We must understand that life is first spiritual. God is a spirit. Angels are spirits. Satan and his cohorts are spirits. God, Jesus, the Holy Ghost, and holy angels, or Satan and his demons affect every life on earth. Is that true? We're also spirits made up of three parts, spirit, soul, and body. As spiritual beings, we put God's spiritual laws into operation through prayer, right? That's what did you guys forget what we're talking about tonight? Come on. Hallelujah. We're talking about kingdom prayer tonight. And so what we're going to do, you're a spiritual being, okay? You don't have a spirit in you, okay? You are a spirit, okay? You are a spirit. Say that. Say, I am a spirit.
I am a spirit.
And say,
the Holy Spirit
is living in my spirit. Okay, that's a gospel fact, amen? And so as a spiritual being, you're going to put God's spiritual laws into operation through prayer. You're going to do your part. You're going to pray. You're going to believe. You're going to be a doer of God's word, and you're going to see great results. Amen? And your life is going to be changed. I'm trying to get you guys excited tonight. Some of you look sad, though. Come on, smile for me. Everybody got to smile. Hallelujah. Praise God. So kingdom prayer wages warfare against evil spirits. You know, I was listening to a powerful man of God. His name is Carlos Anacondia. And he has had one of the most effective and one of the greatest ministries on the planet since like the 80s. And he says in his book, The Game Changer, the reason he has had revival for years, I mean decades, is because of intercessory prayer. Amen? You have to do your part. You cannot be effective in the kingdom and be comfortable at the same time and be lazy. Hallelujah. Now, I'm not trying to discourage you. I'm trying to keep it real with you tonight. Amen? This is not church, okay? Just so you know, this is not a church, okay? This is the kingdom in operation right here. Amen? And so you're going to hear things you might not hear in the church. I'm not going to ask you for a tithe here, although I say we should give here. Amen. But I'm not worried about that. We're not worried about that here. We want you to know the truth, and we want you to hear things that are going to help you. Okay? And what you need to know is that intercessory prayer is going to change your life, the life of your children, the life of your family, and the life of your friends. And that you cannot be lazy, and you cannot be passive. Amen. You have to be aggressive. You have to be courageous. You have to say, Jesus, yes, you are who you say that you are. Jesus, yes, I am who you say that I am. Jesus, yes, I can do what you said I can do. But be ye doers of the word and not hearers only. What about John 14:12? He that believeth on me, the works I do shall he also do. And greater works. Come on, how about that? Greater works than these shall he do, because I go unto my Father. And whatever you ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If you ask anything in my name, I will do it. Amen. If you love me, keep my commandments. That's plain and simple. Amen. Do you love Jesus?
Yes.
Then you must be a doer of his word. Amen. Yes. Hallelujah. Come on, give him a hand clap. Thank you, Lord. Have your way in this place. I'm going to just ask the Holy Ghost to just light a fire in you guys. You guys, you're going to be on fire before you leave tonight. Hallelujah. The rest of this year, you're going to be on fire. This is going to be the greatest 6 months of the rest of this year. Amen. Fire, passion, Holy Ghost boldness, faith, grace, mercy. Hallelujah. Say, I believe it. So once again, kingdom prayer wages warfare against a defeated devil. We are not fighting flesh and blood, people that you can see. Don't allow the devil to get you angry at people. We need to be able to see that. If that were the case, I'd be fired a long time ago. Co-workers are demonized, crazy people. Amen. You have to be able to say, devil, I know what you're trying to do, devil. Not today. I'm not going to get mad at that person. I'm going to bless that girl. I'm going to bless that dude. Amen. Don't get angry and lash out carnally and lose your job. Amen. Hallelujah. We're not fighting against flesh and blood, people that we can see. Instead, we're wrestling against organized evil spirits operating in the unseen world. God has entrusted his church with a prayer ministry to change circumstances and destinies for eternity. That is good. Without God, man cannot. Without man, God will not. God wants to use you. Amen. That's a lame attitude, Wall. If God wants to do this and God wants to get that done, well, then God's just going to go ahead and do it on his own. That's demonic. That's a demonic thought. Amen? Yep. We need to be able to say, yes, Lord. What do you want to do, Lord? What do you want to do in my life? God wants to use your strategic prayer to accomplish his perfect will in your life. Ephesians chapter 8 tonight, say, I'm going to have to pray. I'm going to pray. I'm going to get excited about prayer. I'm going to be strategic about prayer. Amen, amen. Sometimes we've got to just say things before we believe them, amen. That was supposed to be funny. But yes, just say it and act on it and believe it. Amen. It's good stuff. So Ephesians 6, 12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, or against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So we know who the enemy is. The word of God is spiritual law and the will of God. Once again, the word of God is spiritual law and the will of God. The spiritual realm is governed by the word of God. This is why we must pray the word of God, not pray our problems. Okay? Praying the word affects the spiritual realm because the word is spiritual law. Then we can change, influence, or shape our circumstances in what we see. Mark 11, 24. Therefore, Jesus said, therefore I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and then you will have them. Amen. Yes, that's what he said. Believe that you receive them first spiritually according to God's word. Amen. When we pray, we thank him for it. Amen. According to his word, Jesus, if you're ill, if the doctor gave you an evil report, Jesus Christ, this doctor said I have this. But according to your word, by your stripes I am healed. Jesus, you died for my divine healing. The Bible says in Mark chapter 16, verse 17 and 18, you shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 24, by whose stripes ye were healed. Exodus chapter 15, verse 26, I am the Lord that healeth thee. And Jesus Christ, according to your word and according to your promise, I say, disease, leave my body right now. Hallelujah. And then you just say, Father, I thank you that you're alive. Father, I thank you that you're at work in my life. Father, I thank you for the promises of God. Holy Ghost, I thank you that you're living inside of me. Holy Ghost, I thank you that you're quickening my body. And you praise him for the gift and the promise that is already yours according to the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. You're not going to pray the problem. You're not going to say, well, I have this and the doctor said this, and I'm going to believe that doctor more than I believe somebody I can't see. Because you can't see Jesus. But you're going to believe him. Amen. I love what Peter said. I don't know exactly where it's at, but he said, whom you believe in, but you don't see. What was that? I don't know where it's at, but Peter said that you believe in Jesus, though you don't see him. and you have a joy unspeakable. Remember that verse? I don't know where it's at. I need to go there and meditate on it. So once again, we're going to believe that you receive it, then you're going to have it. Kingdom prayer is releasing the power and ability of God in any given situation. That is good. The power or ability of God is in the Word of God, right? The power and ability of God is in the Word of God. When you pray the Word of God, we release the ability and the dunamis power of God. Prayer releases ability and dunamis in the spiritual realm to influence and change and shape circumstances in the natural realm. Prayer is putting God's word or his voice into action. That is real good. Prayer is putting God's word and his voice into action and seeing supernatural results. I'm telling you, if you'll make that decision that you're going to be a prayer warrior, you're going to see your life is going to change. Amen. Do you believe that? I believe that with all my heart. Joel 2:11, the Bible says, "And Jehovah hath given forth his voice before his force. For very great is his camp, for mighty is the doer of his word." That is good news. I'll read that again because you're so excited. Yeah. "And Jehovah hath given forth his voice before his force. For very great is his camp, for mighty is the doer of his word." That is, say, that's me. That's us. Amen. Let's look at Matthew chapter 6, verse 19 through 13 quickly. Man, time's going by quick. Look at that. If you have a device or a Bible, Matthew chapter 6, verses 9 through 13. It's the Lord's Prayer. It's not an actual prayer. It's something that we vainly repeat daily. It's just the manner that we should pray. And Jesus said in verse 9, "In this manner, therefore, pray. Our Father in heaven." So God was going to be our Father, and we are to have a relationship with him. The Old Testament never prayed to God as their Father. Amen? We need to be able to connect with God relationally. When we're praying to God, how does God see you? Right? You're the new creation. You're forgiven. You're holy, unblemished, without wrinkle by the blood. He sees you righteous. You're loved. You're a conqueror. You're an overcomer. Let's focus on identity in the Christ when we approach the Christ. When we draw nigh to God, when we're praying, let's come to him in the identity he's given us. Don't come to God as a failure and a loser, feeling bad about yourself, feeling down about yourself and negative about yourself, self-rejected and self-hated. Amen? Come to him, precious and valuable, somebody that he died for. Did Jesus die for you? Amen. Yes, he certainly did. Hallelujah. So we can approach him with the identity he's given us. We have a new identity in Jesus Christ. In verse 10, "Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." Speaks of the rule and reign of the kingdom of God. The Greek word for kingdom is basileia, which means the king's dominion. It means the rule and reign of the king on earth. It also means royal power. Hallelujah. So the New Testament prayer will bring, kingdom prayer is going to bring God's will when we pray the word of God. The will of God shall be performed on the earth. Amen. Verse 11 says, "Give us this day our daily bread." Any Catholics in here? I said that prayer all the time as a Catholic. We said it every day. I'm sorry? You used to be a Catholic? Okay. Yeah.
I think you're talking about John 20 and 29 where he says to Peter, "Blessed are you because you have seen and believed, but blessed are those who have not seen and believed."
No, it's a different verse. It's in Peter's epistle. So verse 11, "Give us this day our daily bread." This releases God's provision to meet our daily needs. Amen. I believe Christ here was also talking about his word. Let's be a church submitted to the word of God. And we can also, people of the word, Isaiah 55:11, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but shall accomplish that which I please. And it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it." Verse 12, Jesus said, "And forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors." I believe that God is calling us to just be, to forgive. Amen. You know why people stop coming to church, people get offended. People, you know, unforgiveness is of the enemy. We cannot expect God to do anything for us if we cannot forgive other people. And we know what Jesus said in Matthew 6, 14 and 15. For if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you. Right? So we need to forgive. Is that what Christ is saying there in verse 12? Verse 13, Jesus said, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. That declares that prayer will keep us from falling into the temptation and that we will overcome satanic attacks of evil. Deliver us from sickness and disease and mental and emotional problems. Amen. Deliverance literally means to rescue. And Jesus is in the process of rescuing you, and he wants to use you to help rescue other people. Is that true? He wants us to war a good warfare. In 2 Timothy 2:4, Paul said, no one engaged in warfare entangles himself with this in the affairs of this life that he may please him who enlisted him as a soldier. Right? You've been enlisted as a soldier. The rest of verse 13, Jesus said, for yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Say that with me tonight. Say, for yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Wasn't that a powerful manner of prayer that Christ taught us? And that I believe that shows us the release of God's rule and reign, his kingdom and his miraculous ability of God, his power and the manifested presence of God for his glory when we pray. Amen. Look at John chapter 16, verses 23 through 26. John chapter 16, verses 23 through 26. Jesus said, you guys with me? You guys learning something tonight? Okay, praise God. So Jesus said, in that day you will ask me nothing. Most assuredly, I say to you, whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. Until now, have you asked nothing in my name? Ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. So let's study that word ask for a moment. There's two separate words in the Greek here. One word is erotaho, which simply means to ask a favor or make a request or beg. The other word that Christ used there is aitheo, which means to make a legal demand of something that is due us, to require, to desire, and call for. Okay, so let's read that again now that we know what those words mean. And in that day you will ask, erotaho, ask a favor or beg, mean nothing. Most assuredly I say to you, whatever you ask, is the word aitheo, which means to make a legal demand of something that is due you or requires something. The Father in my name, he will give you. Until now, have you asked? That's aitheo, a legal demand of something due. Nothing in my name. Ask, that's that same word again, aitheo, a legal demand of something due, and you will receive, that your joy may be full. So what Jesus was actually saying is we should not request as a favor anything and beg. We don't need to beg God for anything, amen? Instead, you make a legal demand of something that is due us legally according to what Christ has already done for us, amen? Legally demanding something in prayer means that because you are the new creation and a born-again believer, we don't have to beg or ask favors or hope that God will one day answer us. No, we're heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ. All the promises of God are already belong to you. The Bible says, by his stripes you were healed. Okay, so legally they're already yours. Isaiah said, by his bruise there is healing to us. So the gospel is a legal document that defeated and trampled the enemy. And now because of that legal action that was taken at the cross and by the shed blood of Christ, every promise of God is due us, and we can confidently, boldly, courageously ask and legally require these promises God has given us because of what Jesus has done for us. Do you believe that?
Yes.
Okay. Say this with me. Say, my promise is coming.
My promise is coming.
Because it's legally mine.
It's legally mine.
Hallelujah. It's true. Kingdom prayer is similar to writing a check. Amen. First, we put cash in the bank, right? First, we put the cash in the bank, and Jesus said, Jesus has already put all the promises of God in our heavenly bank. And just as the money is already yours, right, the promises legally belong to us. So writing a check makes a legal demand on the bank, just as prayer, a legal demand of the kingdom. When we make a legal demand upon the bank, we are not forcing the bank to give us the money. The money is already yours, right? We are simply releasing it for our benefit. Matthew chapter 18, verse 19, Jesus said, "And again, I say to you that if two of you agree on earth concerning anything that they ask," that is that same word, aietheo, which means to require something or to legally demand it, "it will be done for them by my Father in heaven." Tonight, we're going to make a legal demand for your release from darkness, okay? Tonight, we're going to make a legal demand that sickness leave your body. And it's going to happen. Do you believe it? Ephesians 3:20. Paul said, "Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we ask," that's that same word, "or think according to the power that works in us." So prayer is commanding with God and breaking the enemy's power. It's quiet in here. Do you believe it? Kingdom prayer is commanding with God and breaking the devil's power. In Luke 10:19, Jesus said, "Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and on all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." That word tread there is a verb. It's an action word. It means to trample and tread down underfoot. He's already been placed under your feet by Jesus Christ. Is that true? Now we're going to trample and tread down. Now we're going to trample him and tread him down underfoot. In other words, Luke 10:19 says, "With the authority delegated to us by Christ, we trample and tread down underfoot all the power of the enemy. Then nothing can hurt you." That is what prayer is. Amen. Romans 16:20, Paul said, "And the God of peace shall bruise Satan under your feet quickly," or shortly. Joshua chapter 1, verse 3, "Every place the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you as I said unto Moses." Tonight we learn what kingdom prayer is. Tonight we're going to put this into action tonight. We're going to repent, we're going to forgive, and we're going to break the enemy's power, and we're going to see God manifest his kingdom and his power and his glory in this place. Are you ready? Yes. Mark chapter 16, verse 17 and 18, "These signs shall follow them that believe in my name. Shall they cast out devils, speak with new tongues, take up serpents. If they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover." I hope I encouraged you guys tonight about prayer. I believe with all my heart that prayer is going to be the reason why your life is changed, that your destiny will be changed, the trajectory of your life will be changed because of prayer. You were a man and a woman of prayer. You became a prayer warrior. Amen? I'm done. Let's pray. Let's get down to the Father's business. That was quick. That was practical. I hope we learned some tonight. Let's every eye close, every head bow. Lord, thank you for tonight, for the people of God in this place. Jesus, have your way tonight. Touch your people tonight, Lord. Thank you for the promises that we're going to receive tonight. Thank you that we can require and make a legal demand of all your promises because the Christ has already paid for them. Jesus, thank you that you're here. Thank you for your delivering grace in this place. By the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace which was bestowed on me was not in vain, but I labored more abundantly than they all, yet not I, but the grace of God which was with me. Thank you, Lord. Have your way. Bless your people. Reveal your power and reveal your glory. Destroy darkness in this place. Manifest divine healing power, divine power for your glory. In Jesus' name. Say this prayer with me, church. Say, "Father, in Jesus' name, I repent of all sin, known and unknown. I ask you to cleanse me from all unrighteousness by the blood of the Lamb. And by divine power, thank you for a clean slate. Thank you that I'm the new creation and I'll never be the same. Thank you that I can be a man and a woman of prayer that is going to change my life. In Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, give him a hand clap. Thank you, Lord. You know, people have hurt us. People lied about us. You may have been attacked. You may have been molested. The devil is a dirty, rotten devil. And he'll use people to bring trauma, to bring hurt and pain. But I want to encourage you right now to forgive. Amen. Let's forgive. Let's do it right now. Whoever that you ask God who you need to forgive, that when you hear that person's name, you have ought and you have these crazy emotions when you hear that person's name. And you get angry when you hear that person's name, when you see that person. Let's release them to the cross. Say this with me. Say, Father, in Jesus' name, I forgive everybody that has ever harmed me, hurt me, attacked me, ridiculed me, and brought any trauma in my life. I release them to the cross. In Jesus' name. Satan, you can't use that against me anymore. Because I forgive them. And I bless them. And I'm going to pray for them. In Jesus' mighty name. Come on, take a few more seconds right now. Whoever needs to be forgiven, say that person's name. Just do it right now. Obey the Holy Ghost. Forgive your ex-husband. For somebody needs to forgive their uncle that hurt them. Somebody in high school hurt you, took advantage of you. Forgive them in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Yes. As you do that, you're just opening your heart to divine healing will begin to flow. Your heart is being softened right now. God is touching your heart. He's preparing you for a breakthrough because you're releasing that ought, because you're releasing that anger and that hatred, and you're forgiving that person. Thank you, Lord. Have your way with the people, with the beautiful people of God tonight. Unforgiveness, I bind you. Take your filthy claws off the people of God right now. Negative emotions, emotional death, hatred, self-hatred, ought, anger, discouragement. You release the people of God according to Matthew chapter 16, verse 19. I command you, let them go right now in Jesus' mighty name. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. That word destroy is the Greek word luo, to release. You are being released right now as you forgive. You are being released from darkness. Tonight is your breakthrough. You are being released from the lies of the enemy. Tonight is your night. You are being released from torment. Tonight is your night. You are being released from bondage. Tonight is your breakthrough. That mountain of death is moving right now. Whoever says under this mountain, be thou removed. As a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, as a priest of the living God, you rotten, defeated devil, take your filthy claws off her mind right now. In Jesus' mighty name. Bo, 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 yeah, 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 yeah. Come on, church, right now. Just charge that devil to release you. Just charge that devil to release you. Come on, I want you guys to rise up in Holy Ghost courage and boldness. Father, drop new courage in them. They're never going to be the same. They'll be afraid of nothing in Jesus' name. Father, give them new courage. New courage. New courage. Courage to pray. Courage to fight. Fight, fight. In Jesus' name, take your filthy claws off the daughter of God now. Now, now. Rotten devil. By divine power. By divine power. Come out of her. Come out of her. Go. Go. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Tell him, say, release me, devil. Release me now. Release me now. Come out of me now. Come out of me now. Come out of me now. Say, disease, go in Jesus' name. Disease, go in Jesus' name. Legally, go in Jesus' name. You must leave my body legally right now. By the Christ. In the name of the Christ. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name, let the people go, devil, right now. Let them go in Jesus' name. Let them go, you defeated devil, right now. In Jesus' name. Unforgiveness, hatred, jealousy, come out of them right now. 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 Go, go, go in Jesus' name. Now, now, go, go, go in Jesus' name. Passivity, passivity, I break that chain. I break that curse. I break that curse in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, church, fight. Come on, we talked about prayer tonight. I want you to pray. I want you to fight. You're an army. You're a kingdom warrior. You're a kingdom warrior now. You're a kingdom warrior. You're a daughter of the kingdom. In the name of Jesus, mental illness, confusion, forgetfulness, mistrust, distrust, doubt. Come out of her. Go, go, go. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. I break that chain. I break that yoke right now. I break that yoke in Jesus' name. I break every curse. I break every demon power. Demon chains. Demon powers. Let her go. Let her go. Release her. Release her. Take a deep breath. Get it out of your lungs. They come out of the lungs. Take a deep breath. Take a deep breath. Say, go, devil. Go. Go. Come out of me now. Come out of me now. Go. Let her go. Let her go in Jesus' name. Let her go in Jesus' name. Let her go in Jesus' name. Go. Go. Go in Jesus' name. You need a good deep breath or even a good yawn and a cough. Go.
Release her now.
Go. Now. 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 Come out of her. Come out of her by the power of God. By the power of God. By the power of God. By the power of God, let her go. By the power of God, let her go. By the power of God, let her go. Now, now, by the love of God, I say go. By the love of Jesus, I say go. Go right now. Go right now. Go right now. Go right now. In the name of Jesus, come out of her. Go. Go. I break that witchcraft curse. Ouija board. I break your power. Occult. I break your power. In Jesus' name. Occult. Witchcraft. I break your power. Witchcraft. I break your power. Go. 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 Now. Now. Come out of her. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. By the love of God, release her. By the love of God, release her. Come on, fight, church. I want you to fight. I want you to get mad at the devil. Are you mad at the devil? Are you angry yet? He is trying to kill you. He is trying to steal, kill, and destroy. Are you mad at Satan yet? If you are not mad at the devil, you ought to be mad. You ought to get mad at the devil. Do it right now. It's going to help you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Thank you, Lord. Right now. Thank you, Lord, for the daughter of God. I say in the name of Jesus, be restored and be healed now. Forevermore. You devil, you take your filthy hands off her mind right now. You let her go. You let her go. I curse sickness at the roots now in the name of Jesus. Now, go, come out of her. What's going on with you? What do you want to focus on? You're not sure? Okay. What's his name? Christian? Lord, I thank you for Christian. In the name of Jesus. Have your way in his life. I break every generational curse right now. I break demon power. Every demonic yoke. Every occult witchcraft bondage in the name of Jesus. As a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ, I break your power, Satan, now in Jesus' name. You're going to let him go, devil. You're going to let him go, Satan, right now. Let his mind go. Let him go right now in Jesus' mighty name. Let him go. I want you to just start, I want you to renounce the devil right now. Say in Jesus' name, I renounce the devil. I renounce all of his works. I renounce the witchcraft. I renounce the occult in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Satan, you are going to let me go. I will get my life back in Jesus' name. I am a man of God. I am a servant of God. I am a son of God. Satan, you must leave me right now. I want you to get mad, okay, brother? What does he need deliverance from? What's going on with him?
Discouragement?
Rejection? Okay. Is there drug addiction or is there like, is there... Okay. So all of those are just symptoms of what's really wrong. Who hurt you? Did somebody hurt you? Your dad or someone took advantage of him? Okay, well, you want to forgive your dad right now, brother? Huh? Yeah. What's your dad's name? What's his dad's name? You want to forgive Greg? The devil is trying to destroy your life through your dad, but we need to forgive. You need to forgive him. You want to do it? Say in Jesus' name, I forgive my dad. I release him right now. I bless him in Jesus' name. All right, Satan, you heard that. You must take your filthy hands off this man of God right now. In Jesus' mighty name, witchcraft, curses, bondages, demon powers, agreements with hell, demon yokes, agreements with Satan, covenants with hell, in the name of Jesus Christ, I break your power right now. Right now. Let him go. Rejection, come out. Rejection, come out of him. Take a deep breath. Get a good yawn or a cough. Go. Go in Jesus' name. There it is. Now, in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Keep going. Out in Jesus' mighty name. Come out of them. Right now, rejection, fear, bondage, self-rejection, pain, memories. In the name of Jesus, painful memories, heartache, heartbreak, fear, anxiety, perversion. Come out of them right now. Take a deep breath. Come out of them right now. Go in Jesus' mighty name. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, come out of them. Come out of them. Come out of them now. Come out of them now. Go ahead, deep breath or a good cough. You too. Go. Go in Jesus' name. You're getting deliverance too. Go in Jesus' name. Come out of her in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Fight, fight, fight. Go in Jesus' name. Fight, 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 fight. Go, go, go. In Jesus' mighty name.
I trust in your ways.
You let her go. Let her go now. Let her go now. Let her go right now. Let her go right now. I say in Jesus' name, I command you, devil, out now. Out right now. Out now. Go. Go in Jesus' name. Go. Out. Go. Go in Jesus' name. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Give me a good deep breath or a good breath. Release, a good release of breath. Go, go, right now, in Jesus' name. You lose her, let her go. Let her go. Let her go. Let her go. Say, I renounce all witchcraft. I renounce all the witchcraft. In Jesus' name. Devil, come out of me right now. 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 Let me go right now. Let me go right now. Go, go, In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, you rotten devil, come out of the people right now. Mental illness, emotional, physical, verbal abuse, sexual abuse. Come out of them right now. Come out of them right now. In the name of Jesus, Satan, let her go right now. Let her go in Jesus' mighty name. I break every chain. I break every curse now. I break every curse now. Now. In Jesus' name. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Go. Go. Go in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Drobo Shiko Sandro. Thank you, Lord. Have your way. Have your way with the people of God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, devils of addiction, devils of bad habits, come out of the people right now. In Jesus' mighty name, I say let them go. Let them go right now. In Jesus' name, I bind every devil. In Jesus' name. Matthew chapter 16, verse 17 or 18 and 19. Release the people of God. Release the people of God. Now, devil, let them go. 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 Let her go in Jesus' mighty name. Let her go in Jesus' mighty name. What's going on?
Pray for my family, my children, my mother, my sister, they're all, he's got them all, you know, I believe it's broken, you know, I've prayed so many times.
Keep praying.
To leave them alone.
Amen.
Leave them.
Amen. Don't quit, don't stop. Your prayer is going to make a difference, amen? Your prayer is going to change the circumstances, okay?
For generations of addictions down to me, it stopped. With me,
hallelujah.
It stopped.
Hallelujah.
He grabbed me, and he took me out of it. And I had to leave them all behind. I had to leave them all in England. I came here to find Jesus. And he found me.
I love
me.
It. Praise
and
God.
He brought me, and he's loved me, and he's told me I'm worthy.
Wow.
My whole family.
You pray in tongues?
Yeah.
You do?
My family rejected me. They just, everyone rejected me.
It's okay.
Who will never reject you?
Yes. Yes.
That's why he brought me here.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Oh, ra-ba-ba-ba-ba. Lord, I pray for new fire, new power in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Have your way with the daughter of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for healing life. The life of the Christ in her soul. Thank you, Lord. Receive the life of Jesus right now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name. Now you listen to me, Satan. I command you to let her go. Release her. Let her mind go right now. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Do you have any kind of disease or any sickness?
Oh God, I'm healed.
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 Praise God.
Thank you.
If there's anybody here that doesn't pray in tongues, come up here so you can be baptized in the Holy Ghost. If there's anybody that doesn't pray in tongues, come up here, please. Yes.
It just seems like a something that would cause one to be slumped, like easily sleep. I tend to like fall asleep in lectures and class, or you know, like I kind of like fatigue, like low energy. Is there anything like that?
I don't know. But let's pray for energy and power. Father, I thank you for the man of God, and I pray that you would energize him by your fire and by your word, that he will be alert and be ready when you need him to be, God. That he would get healthy rest and at night and sleep good so that he wouldn't have this problem with fatigue. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Yes, yeah, I mean, be practical. Make sure you're getting your rest, okay?
1 Peter 1:8.
Yes, that's what it is?
Yeah.
Okay, I couldn't think of it.
So thanks so much for those notes, by the way.
Oh, you're welcome.
I actually need them tonight if you were going to give them away.
Yeah, you can have them.
Unless you got them. They're so awesome. I mean, in my time, I'm going through divorce, and it's like the word of God directly for me.
Right, there you go.
I really appreciate it.
Oh, brother.
You're an encouragement, brother.
Praise God. Are you praying in tongues?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Okay. If you don't pray in tongues, come up here. Or if you need a miracle, if you want us to pray for healing, come up here, please. We're going to pray for a healing right now. Whatever the miracle is that you need, the miracle worker, Jesus Christ, is here. What's going on?
I'm an intercessor, and I had a high satanic leader pray a curse over me. So I'm standing against that, and I know that.
Who placed that over you?
Satanic leader.
Okay.
A satanic church.
Okay. All right. In the name of Jesus Christ, I break every generational curse right now. And I say, devil, you will not have a hold on her. You will not have a stronghold on her in Jesus' name. Release her mind and release her to her destiny, devil, right now. Let her go in Jesus' name. Thou art loosed in Jesus' name. Release her in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, by the power and by the blood of the Lamb. Say, by the blood of the Lamb. I was redeemed from the hand of the enemy. Now, I don't want you to worry about or focus on that satanic leader anymore, okay? I want you to focus on your leader. Who's your leader? Jesus Christ, okay? Focus on him. Fall in love with him. Pursue him. Follow him. But we're not going to worry about some satanic loser.
No.
Give me a high five. Amen. You have the victory, okay? Don't worry about what he's doing. He can't. You're protected by the blood of the Lamb. Okay? Okay?
All right, Peter. I just want God to deliver me from selfishness.
Okay? That's a good one.
And I want God to help me be a selfless.
Selfless.
Yeah.
You're going to just be crucified with Christ. Amen? Say this. Say, Father, in Jesus' name.
Father, in Jesus' name.
I want to be crucified with Christ.
I want to be crucified with Christ.
I want to lay my body as a living sacrifice.
Lay my body as a living sacrifice.
On your altar.
On your altar.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I renounce pride.
I renounce pride.
I renounce evil.
I renounce evil.
I renounce Satan.
I renounce Satan.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Pride.
Pride.
Come out of me right now.
Come out of me right now.
You heard the man of God in Jesus' name. I break that curse. I break that chain. I break those demon powers in Jesus' name. Come out of him now. Come out of him now in Jesus' name. Release him, devil. Release him now. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, go. Let him go. Get a deep breath. Go in Jesus' name. Now, go in Jesus' name. Cough or burp or yawn. Out. Release him now. Unclean spirits of pride. Unclean spirits of lust. Go. Go. Now. Now. Out. Out. Out of him in Jesus' name. Out of him in Jesus' name. Say, come out of me in Jesus' name. Come out of me in Jesus' name. Come out of me in Jesus' name.
I was going to ask you to pray for that lady in that corner. She's really, really sick. Blood clots.
Okay.
Dialysis. I prayed for her for a little bit. She got a little bit better. But Karina just told me that everybody's prayed for her.
Okay.
So maybe you
can. Yeah, I will.
After you're done.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, that'd be great. What's up, brother? How can we pray for you?
Okay.
I just say in Jesus' name, I renounce every soul tie.
I renounce every soul tie.
Every body tie.
Every body tie.
All sexual sin.
All sexual sin.
I repent.
I repent, Lord.
By the blood of the Lamb.
By the blood of the Lamb.
Father, I ask you to make me clean.
Father, I ask you to make me clean.
Wash me by your word.
Wash me by your word.
Cleanse me by the blood.
Cleanse me by the blood.
I am redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. In
Jesus' name.
I forgive everybody that ever hurt me. In Jesus' name. I release those people to the cross. I forgive them and bless them now. In
Jesus' name.
I renounce all the authority
that I have
given Satan
through all sexual sin.
In Jesus' name, right now. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Okay, you heard that, Satan. In Jesus' name, I break your power. I break that demon chain of sexual sin and perversion. I break that bondage. I break demon powers right now, witchcraft. Sexual sin, perversion. I break your power now in Jesus' mighty name. You're going to let him go right now, you rotten devil. Come out of him. Let his mind go. Let his soul go. Come out. Release him now. Release him right now in Jesus' name. Take a deep, good breath. Go out in Jesus' name. Out in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. Go. Go, release him now. Come out of him now. In Jesus' name, go out. Out right now. Perversion, soul ties, body ties, sexual sin. Come out of him now. Come out of him now. Go in Jesus' name. I say go in Jesus' mighty name. I say go. 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 I want you to fight. Come on, take a deep breath.